sir. So,
what was the
yes, today I'm going to present our work on correlation of histopathology of trabecular meshwork with clinical features in primary congenital glaucoma. So, no financial disclosures. We all know that primary congenital glaucoma is a type of childhood glaucoma that is associated with abnormal development of trabecular meshwork, and surgical therapy is a mainstay of its management. Presently, we use primarily combined trabeculotomy with trabeculectomy for its management. So we believe that better understanding of histopathology of trabecular meshwork may allow for better targeted therapy of this disease in the future. However, there is limited literature in this regards. So we performed a prospective study to correlate the histopathology of trabecular meshwork with clinical features and long-term prognosis as an interventional non-controlled study at our center. After obtaining ethical clearance and informed consent from the institute as well as the parents or the guardians. So we included all the consecutive children who were aged less than 1 year at diagnosis and aged less than 2 years when operated, whereas children with coexistent ocular systemic pathology and children whose samples did not show trabecular meshwork and histopathological examination were excluded. So after obtaining a detailed history and undertaking a detailed general examination and pediatric evaluation, we performed an ophthalmic evaluation for these children, and we assessed corneal diameters, intraocular pressure, fundus details, central corneal thickness, axial length at baseline, and all these children were medically managed for 1 week to see whether medical management can be sufficient for this. When the medical management was not sufficient, we proceeded with primary combined trabeculotomy with trabeculectomy with mitomycin C, where mitomycin C 0.04% was put 3 minutes subconjunctively, subclearly, and 1 minute subconjunctively. The trabecular meshwork tissue that was obtained during this surgery was sent for histopathological examinations, and multiple qualitative as well as quantitative features were looked for. The children were again evaluated on day one, first 1 month, 1 month one, 6 months, and 12 months after surgery, and multiple parameters including bleb assessment was undertaken. We defined surgical success as IOP less than 14 millimeter mercury on medical or surgical management, and following which the data statistical analysis was done. So we included 39 children in our study, where maximum children were less than 1 month when at presentation, and the ironic contrastingly, we found more females in our study, and this could be attributed to our variable selection criteria, where we included only those children where histopathological specimen were positive. The most common symptoms were cloudy cornea in our children. This indicates that how severe the presentation is for our kids, where lacrimation and photophobia come second to all these severe symptoms. So we also found that bilateral association was seen in 84%, which is quite common of these PCG patients, and medical management could control the IOP in only 6% of patients, with 85% requiring surgery. So out of the 66 eyes where we performed surgical management, we evaluated them prospectively and compared them with medically managed eyes also. So we found that in the surgically managed eyes, the corneal diameters more or less remained stable with only minimal increase from 12.57 to 12.67 at 12 months of follow-up. So but the most striking feature was that the cornea cleared in around 58% patients, and a cup disc ratio reversal was seen from 0.65 to 0.49 at 12 months after surgery, with maximum reversal occurring within first 1 month. So this shows the severity of PCG cases in our center, where we can see the corneal opacity is so severe that all the posterior segment details are very much limited to examine. So this shows early presentations where half stries can be seen, but the cornea is not so compromised and you can actually evaluate the patient. So when coming to the IOP, we found that the mean IOP of 29.76 decreased to 11.88 at 12 months, and the maximum IOP reduction occurred immediately after surgery within 1 month. Percentage decrease in IOP was statistically significant between medical and surgical management, again supporting our management that we have undertaken. So when compared to other studies where bleb changes were not reported, our study noticed a significant change in the type of bleb over a period of first 6 months. The bleb changed from a well-formed type to a thin cystic type over a period of first 6 months, and these are the various types of bleb that we have seen. So we can see that there is a well-formed bleb, flat bleb, and thin cystic bleb, which are compared. So we saw a significant change from one type of bleb to the last type of bleb in our study, and this we attributed to our surgeon factors, where all the surgeries were undertaken by one single surgeon. So coming to the histopathological results of the 66 eyes, we found that a lesionophilic membrane was present at the aqueous side of our specimens in around for 23 IZT 35% cases. This is again supportive of Barkan's view. However, unlike Wurst, who told that only this man is responsible for raised IOP in PCG children, our study did not support this because it was absent in 65% cases and still the IOP was raised. So we found that the trabecular meshwork beams were fused in around 54%, either partially or totally. And despite the fusion occurring in 54% cases, the intervening spaces were seen in 60% of cases. And this we could attribute to because we also included the spleral side of the trabecular meshwork in counting spaces. The pleomorphic trabecular endothelial cells were seen in 17% cases, and most of the trabecular cells were pleomorphic in high cellular specimens. High cellular specimens were a little lesser than the low cellular specimens, which are the highest one, which contributed to our trabecular meshwork findings. So these are the various photographs of histopathological changes of trabecular meshworks seen in our children. We found that A and B suggest low cellular specimens, where B also suggests there is presence of eosinophilic membrane. C and D suggest moderately cellular specimens with presence of intercellular spaces. And E and F present high cellular specimens with pleomorphism that can be clearly appreciated. So when we see that, when we correlated this to clinical and histopathological findings, we found that the endothelial cell density correlated directly with trabecular meshwork thickness. That means the thicker specimens were had more trabecular cells, and this trabecular meshwork thickness again correlated negatively with cup disc ratio at the presentation. So fused trabecular beams were also, so higher number of fused trabecular beams were associated with higher excellence and higher baseline IOP, and eosinophilic membrane was again associated with lower IOP and lower excellence. Pleomorphic cells and hypercellularity were associated with again increased abnormal lower corneal diameter set at 12 months, which did not correlate with our baseline findings. A control IOP of less than 20 baseline IOP, higher baseline IOP was seen in eyes which were actually having thicker specimens at presentation. So we found that those specimens which did not have high cellular trabecular meshwork, the success rate was higher, and there was no failure in those cases. So lower baseline CCT and higher excellence. That is higher excellence. It suggests with all the features of hypercellular trabecular meshwork and higher baseline fused beam suggests that a thick subcanalicular tissue is responsible for this early severe form of PCG in our kids. Although presence of clear intervening spaces may be expected to have lower IOP, but raised IOP in these kids because
sir,
because
your
of
time is over.
Yes, just two minutes, sir.
Please come.
Yes. We had certain limitations, like we could not have controls and our sample size was slightly limited, so we believe more studies are required. So from this our study we can conclude that performing a light microscopic analysis may guide prognosis of PCG. However, maintaining a lower postoperative IOP is more important than all other baseline features for control of disease. So, and more targeted therapies can be targeted in the future for better medical management of PCG. Thank you.